the aftermath of the trial of the Bideford women is, you know, what do we know afterwards? We have this vignette of history where we have very clear information. Most of these people vanish completely. Careful searches have found a bit about people. John Hill, the town clerk of Bideford, nothing. Judge Raymond carried on doing some trials. He died fairly soon afterwards, as did Lord North, the Lord Chief Justice, I think. But he died. He was ill already at the time of the trials. And other people in the trials, the families and of the people. Well, we do know from the parish records, for example, some of the victims who claimed to be ill and claimed to be bewitched, yes, they did die within 3 or 4 years from whatever condition they had. We don't think it was witchcraft. They probably felt, yes, they were bewitched, and even though witches had died, somehow, actually, can you think about it, they believed in those days, if you killed the witch, then the bewitching would no longer take place. Well, I'm afraid when Grace died, it's undermined her own case. But it's such a sad story, really. These people, it all came together to a head in 1682, and people died in consequence of misunderstandings, of ignorance, even though the Secretary of State, Sir Leoline Jenkins, he agreed they probably weren't guilty of witchcraft, no such thing as witches. It was expedient they die. He was right. He was afraid of rebellions in the West, and they did happen 3 years later, and many people died in consequence. He argued secretly to his colleague, the judge, that they should die made sense rather than for the sake of peace and order in the kingdom.